Welcome back to Fit for Life with Karen. And today we're going to talk about water. Water, water everywhere. Most of us are not getting enough, and I think we know that. But I think after I give you a little information you might not know about it, I think you're going to start drinking water. Again, always check with your doctor. Sometimes they're not sure what to tell you. 8 glasses a day is recommended. But if you're eating lots of fruits and vegetables, you're drinking coffee, milk, or juice, you're getting all your liquids there too, your fluids. So keep that in mind. Why do we need to hydrate? That's what I'm going to tell you about now. But first, before we start, I'd like to do our thought for the day, because I think it just kind of sets the mood. Thoughts for the day. It says, never regret. I think we all have those. Never regret. If it's good, it's wonderful. And if it's bad, it's experience. It says writer Victoria Holt. Some of you might be familiar with her. The second one, because these are short, as long as you can admire and love, then one is young forever. And I think that's really true. It says musician Pablo Casals, and I believe he was the cellist. So short and sweet, but it says a lot. All right, I wrote this down today myself. Who drinks 8 glasses a day anyway? There are other ways to get water, as I said, fruits and vegetables, especially lettuce, celery, and cucumbers, which are really, really good for many, many things. I have a whole page of all the things that does for us. So someday we'll talk maybe just about nutrition. We'll do a little exercise, but nutrition is really important, especially as we get older. You want to avoid, at all costs, if possible, dehydration. That also is common with seniors, especially in retirement communities. You want to avoid it. The symptoms could include headache, fatigue, dizziness is the scary one. You can take a fall, hit your head, or you have to be taken to a hospital. You're not really sick, but you are dehydrated, and they need to put more fluid in. So you'll have a bag, and you'll have a needle in your arm. So just keep that in mind. We can avoid those things, but you have to think about it. It's just one more thing we have to do along with all our medications. But if you keep order and you keep things written down, that will help. So we do want to avoid that. And don't wait. This is important. Don't wait until you're thirsty. Then it could be too late. You could be on your way to a fall or a full-fledged dizziness, falling, and being dehydrated, which is a scary feeling, and we don't want that to happen. But we need to exercise now, so I'm going to push back. We're going to do some aerobics to start, just to get your circulation going today. We'll do maybe about 7 or 8 minutes. If you are warming up, try to do at least 10 minutes, or take a 10-minute walk or a 20-minute walk. Pretty soon the weather will be good and you can get out there and do your walking. So let me start the music for you here. Good. All right, get ready. Good. Just bend your knees, nice and easy. Good. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we're just going to touch the toe to the front. Move those arms. Get that heart rate up a little bit. 5, 6, 7. Now your heel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 8. Out to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nice and tall. Good posture, right? Reach. Reach. Little twist. Reach again. Good. Let's reach up. This one you'll feel a little bit more. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Come forward and kick and back. And 1, 2, 3. Kick, let's go back. forward and back, and forward again and back. Lift that knee up. I like this one. It feels good. You're getting a little stretch in the back of your hamstring. Good. And up and up and up. And five and six and seven. Let's stop here now. Just lift your heel up. Second heel, first heel, and alternate. Good. Push those flat hands down. Don't worry about right and left. Just alternate. Good. 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 You're going to come forward again. Toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel. Go back, toe, heel. A nice stretch for the foot. And forward. Move those arms. Great. And back, 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 back. Just kick. What could be easier than this? It's fun. Do this on your own. Much easier with music. And kick. Anyone out of breath? Probably not. I hope not. Great. Kick to the side. One, two, three. This is good for balance, believe it or not. Five and six and seven and eight and one, two, three, four, five, six. We can stop right here now. And bounce again. Good. Three. Maybe you can go a little bit deeper this time. Oh, yeah. Push down and one, two, three, four, and five, and six. Last one coming up. Front, side. Just follow me. I'm your mirror. Front, side, back, close. Front, side, back, and close, and front, and side, and back. Let's do it again. Front, side, back, a little faster this time, and there you are. You've done your aerobics first, or your warm-up. You could call it your warm-up too, couldn't you? Yes. Have a seat and relax. Good. Now what we're going to do is stretch a little bit. Grab some water first. I have my trusty water bottle with me. Left it in my car last night, but it was not frozen. So that means it has good insulation, doesn't it? Here we go, press the button. I should advertise for this company, shouldn't I? Ice cold, I'll tell you that. So we're gonna try to do just kind of an easy all over stretch. How should we start? My hands are wet. Clasp your hands together, turn them over, feet are flat, sitting up straight and get the shoulders down, and you're gonna push out. Now the reason we're stretching is because we just warmed those muscles up. Yes. So you're gonna bring your hands back, then you're gonna push way up. This isn't too bad, but I want you to very gently push back. You'll feel your back flattening out a little bit. You're stretching the shoulders, the upper back. We'll do, let's say this is five coming up. Five and six. Good. And seven and eight. Bring those arms down. Let's grab those elbows again. Bring the shoulders down. Pull that chin in a little bit and pull across. This one's fairly easy, but it feels good. It's effective. Pull across. And then to the other side. You're not holding your breath, doing just your natural breathing. If you want, you can do the yoga breath with every single movement. It will take a little bit longer. We just don't want you to hold your breath when you're stretching. All right, we'll come across. Just lift up, say hello, and bring the arms down. All right, I'm gonna come forward just a little bit, and we're gonna do four stretches for the spine, yes. Just drop forward, that's all. Nice stretch, keep your head up if you have to. All right, so this is spinal flexion. Let's do spinal extension. Do you remember clasping your hands? We just did it. Bring those arms up We'll let go, and then we're going to reach up, way up now, two, you can bring the shoulders up, and three, and four. Now grab that wrist and pull up. Let's get a really good stretch, up, the other side, pull up. Good, you can hold these longer when you do these on your own. Grab that wrist and pull up again. You probably will be taller by the end of this show. And to the other side, good. And then we'll just bring the arms down. So we did spinal flexion. We extended the spine. We flattened out that curve in your upper back, in that cervical area. But the spine can also twist a little bit. So let's do an easy one. Elbows down, natural breathing, shoulders down, and we're just going to twist. Good. Now stay here. Take this hand, cross it in front of your body. Good. And just pull yourself around a little bit more. And now you have perfect posture too. It looks wonderful. It feels wonderful. So just pulling across. Great. And then you'll come back slowly. So this is pretty easy, isn't it? Let's do it with the breath. Breathing up through the nose. And exhale and just do a little bit of a rotation or a twist. This front hand you're going to bring down and just pull yourself a little bit more. You will know when it's time to stop. Are you hearing anything when you do this? Sometimes I get a little cracking there. All right, so we're twisting. So that's pretty good. Feels good. And then we'll come back. All right. Now the spine can also bend. The spine can bend. Take this hand. That would be your right hand, wouldn't it? Cross over. Let's take a breath as we bring the arm up. Shoulders down if you can. As you exhale, you'll bend but reach at the same time. This is not a stretch. I know I say it every single time. I'm programmed. And then we'll bring that arm back up. Now, can you just switch over? Yeah. Up through the nose as you bring the arm up. And reaching again. Oh, that feels good. Up and to the side. Don't let the arm cave in. We don't want an arc. We want straight. Straight arm, good. Can you feel that all the way down the side? That's wonderful. So you can see all the different ways that the spine can move. And you want to keep the spine flexible so you can do it. If you're sitting like this all day or sitting in one position or watching too much television, it's going to be tough to do it. But then you're going to really have to stretch out. So just keep that in mind. Good. Let's do just a little bit more for the upper body. We're just going to just round, make circles with your hands, stretch out those wrists a little bit, give them a little flexibility, back the other way, good. All right, finger to thumb, each finger, back and forth, easy stuff. But if you have arthritis in your hands, this is really good for it, good. Let the hands flop down, come all the way up. Now let me see the palms of your hands and bring those arms down. Try it again. Breathing up through the nose, limp hands, and exhale as I look at the palms. You're just switching the position of your hands. Try it one more time. All the way up, good stretch, and exhale down. So that's not too bad, is it? All right, let's do just a little bit for posture. You're going to come forward in your chair, hands on your knees. But I want you to pull yourself up, shoulders down, pull that chin in. Now you look perfect. Good. We'll just turn to one side. Natural breathing, natural breathing. If you want to do the yoga breath, you're going to breathe up through the nose as you come back. And exhale as you turn to the other side. You're going to keep turning. Wonderful. Great, great. And then we'll come back. Let's do a little bit of stretching for the legs, just a little bit. Heel down, sit up nice and straight, good. Both hands here on your thigh, keep your back straight as you come forward. Wonderful. So we're stretching now just the back of the leg, mostly your hamstring. and then we're going to sit back up again. Normally you would hold that for at least 10 seconds. Let's try it. Keeping the back straight, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, longer than you thought. Ideally 15, 20 if you can do it. When you're on your own and you're at home, you can take all the time you want. I'm just trying to give you ideas. So you might want to bring a pad of paper and a pencil when you turn the TV on to watch the show, so you can jot things down, or things that you don't know or you haven't done and you don't want to forget it, right? All right. So I want to do one more thing. Sit back. All right, we're going to point the toes and flex. So you're stretching the front of your lower leg and the back and the front. And in a couple of minutes, maybe less than that, we're going to stand and we're going to do some ballet work for balance. I try to incorporate balance work in all of my classes. Sometimes we miss, but maybe you'll remember some of them or write them down. But ballet for balance. You need good balance if you're going to get up on point, right? So we're flexing and extending. So it's flexion, extension, or this way, extension, flexion. Good. You can do your hands too if you want. Feels good. Hands are cold today. All right, great. So for the next few minutes, we are going to be ballerinas. If you're a man, we'll call you a male ballet dancer. All right. Grab some water again. Let's take a breath together, breathing up through the nose and holding. And we're going to just exhale out and drop down. Good. And keep your head up. Some of you might be drinking water. Maybe you're finished. So you can drink, you know, during your workouts. You can take a minute, take a little rest to get that water into your body, because it's so important. I was checking on Google the other day, and it says that human beings are about 60% water. Years ago, I had heard 70% and even higher. So different parts of your body have different water content, but on the whole, about 60%. So just knowing that, you know that you need to replenish, right? Okay, arms out, and let's just stand up. Easy enough. I hope you're remembering to do that. And the more you do it, the easier it gets. So it's not for naught. All right, are you ready? I'm going to have you either go to the back of your chair or to the side. And I'm going to stand right here so you can see everything I'm doing. We're going to do something called passe. Now give yourself, well, back here you're fine. I have to give myself a little bit of room because I'm going to be using both sides, all right? So all you're going to do is kind of put your heels very close. They don't have to touch, all right? Good. And you're just going to lift this heel up, put the foot in front, arms out to the side, or hold on if you have to. And you're going to lift up and put it in back. Lift up and put it in front. Lift up and back. Slowly. If you want, you can just take your time, lift the heel up, and then just lift that foot off the floor. Up here and to the front, and up here and to the back. So if you want to, you know, touch the inside of your knee or just the inside of your lower leg, that's fine. But as you practice, you'll be able to do more. It does work. You just have to do it. Again, heels together, we're in first position. Remember that? Let's do a plie. Plie. And then releve. Lift the heels up. So you're doing your little knee bend, plie. And releve means to rise up. Good. But we have to do the other leg, right? So we're going to put that in front. This is fifth position. And you're going to just bring that leg up and put it in back. You can do it quickly at first. And then you'll be able to slow down a little bit and do it a little bit more. Good. And up. And you don't have to take big steps like this. Just put that foot down in front and in back. Take another couple of seconds. Try to slow it down just a little bit. Up, whoops. And if you have a tie shoe, that will help you. I don't want you to work in loafers or bare feet either. We can do bare feet with yoga, but not when we're doing our other exercises. So that's called passé, which means passing from front to back. The next thing we're going to do is arabesque for balance. So I'm going to turn my chair so you can see what I'm doing. You can stay behind your chair if that's where you are, or you can stay at the side of your chair. Arabesque, we'll give you a real simple one, all right? You're just going to touch to the back, that's all. And you're going to lift that leg up. All right, so I've got my... Doesn't matter, I'm not going to say right and left, it's much easier to forget that. Just do the opposite arm in front, all right? Holding, so you're just holding on with one hand now, right? Pull that chin in, shoulders down, nice and tall, and see if you can balance there for a couple of seconds. Even if it's just 2 seconds, try to balance. Good, good, good. Whoops. Try it again, and just hold as long as possible. Sometimes it takes a couple of tries, right? You're going to bend both knees just to relax. Did you hear that? That was my ankle. All right, now you're going to just touch to the back. Opposite arm comes to the front. If you can remember opposite arm, that's all you need to know. Just lift that leg up. You're tightening your glutes here. You're strengthening your lower back also. And keep it low. I'm not asking you to bring it up like that. All right. Just let go with one hand. And then let go with the other hand. And see if you can balance there. Oh, good. I actually did it today. I can't believe it. Let's bend both knees. Just things you can practice on your own. You might only remember one thing that we did for ballet, and just do that. Now again, to strengthen the legs, especially the quadriceps, let's turn the feet out again into a nice second position. So that means the feet are wide. This isn't wide enough. It's got to be really kind of wide, all right? And you're just going to do a plié. That's a knee bend. Good. Look at the knee on the right. Make sure it's over the ankle, maybe a little bit forward of it. Not to the side or inside, right? So we're going to bend those knees. Look at the other side. Make sure that knee isn't here. It's over the ankle or just over the front part of the foot. And you do a plié. Good. So that will strengthen the quadriceps. And then bring the heels up. Heels down. And we'll do that knee bend again. And this is called plié. Remember, this one is called what? Relevé, yes. Do it again. Plié and relevé. One more time. Plié, a great strengthener. And up. All right, good. Now, just relax now for a minute. I just wanted to check our time, see how much time we have left. And all I want you to do, you don't have to move your chairs at all. I'm going to come forward. We're going to end the ballet portion here with a curtsy. I'm assuming most of you are women, right? You're going to step to the side and cross and back. See if you can balance there. Do it behind your chair. That might be the best way to do it. Maybe you're already there. To the other side and cross and just stay there. A nice little curtsy. So you still have both feet on the ground, don't you? Nice and tall, shoulders down, good. The other side, a little curtsy. If you want, you can be really graceful. Bring that arm across, get a little exercise in your upper body. You can do a plié if you want, or just be very regal. There you are, good. See, now you're ballerinas. Good. You'll be on the stage pretty soon. We'll all come to see you. Wonderful. I'll say 5, 6, 7, 8. And the gentlemen in our audience, if there are any, can take their bow. Good. Now you're going to have a seat and do nothing. Grab some water. I'm going to organize the studio here. Come back. This has been kind of a different show today, hasn't it? By the way, this is my 85th show, my 85th exercise show, Fit for Life with Karen, and I am so glad I started it. I'm having a great time, and now and then I'm meeting some people that say they've seen this show, and that's so exciting for me. I really appreciate that. I got a beautiful note from a lady that said that it helped her through the COVID period. And then I finally met her in person, a beautiful woman. And she's coming to one of my classes, so I'm really happy about that. I like to know that it's doing some good, and that's why I'm doing it. I'm trying to make aging a more positive experience. You can do it, but you have to be consistent. You know, keep your spirits up. Try to be with people that lift you rather than toxic people. Sometimes we can't help that. I think there are more good people in this world anyway, but again, there are many things you can do. If you like to read, that helps. Music helps. Just getting out of the house now and then and meeting nice people. All right, I'm going to come forward in the chair just a little bit because we're just about finished. And just bring those arms up. Good. Palms facing. And just turn the body a little bit. We're reaching for the sky. And then we're going to turn to the other side. And then you're going to sit back. We have 1 minute left. And I would like to give you something that's going to relax you. So let's breathe up. You know how to do it. You're breathing up through your nose. Close your eyes like I do. And exhale and let that chin just fall right down. And just know that you've done something good for yourself. You won't be sorry you did it. You've burned some calories too. And because we do strength training, we're burning calories even at rest. Remember that, strength training. And I said this in the last show, strength training raises your metabolism. Isn't that nice to know? But just, you know, don't sit for 3 or 4 hours at a time without getting up. Sometimes we fall asleep, I suppose, but I just want to thank you all for your comments, you know, for viewing, for listening to me, and maybe we'll have a big celebration for my 100th. I'll hire a hall, a big hall. So we'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye-bye.